Okay, time now for a little musical quiz. Name the St. Louisan who is not only a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, but also has the distinction of recording Motown Records' first Grammy Award-winning song.
Now, did you guess Chuck Berry? Wrong. Johnny Johnson? Wrong. Tina Turner is also wrong. Let Fox News' Glenn Zimmerman give you a little hint in tonight's Fox Files.
Tucked away in a quiet, nondescript St. Louis suburb lives a music legend, a Rock and Roll Hall of Famer, a five-time Grammy Award winner, and the lead singer of this iconic song. Say hello to St. Louisan Dennis Edwards.
It was the best thing I ever done was to move back to St. Louis.
Edwards was the lead singer of The Temptations. Yes, those Temptations. His gritty, soulful, gospel voice was the sound of the Motown group in the late 60s and 70s. It's his voice that fueled the number one hits like I Can't Get Next to You, Runaway Child, Running Wild, and Motown's first ever Grammy Award-winning single, Cloud Nine. Before he joined, the group was the Classic Five: David Ruffin, Eddie Kendricks, Otis Williams, Melvin Franklin, and Paul Williams. They had a string of hits in the 60s, but success and drugs were going to David Ruffin's head, and he was on his way out.
He was just a complete entertainer. I didn't know about his personal life, but he's a complete entertainer. Well, anyway, you know, I'm sitting there, man, I'm like, Temptations. So he said, you let me know. So I went home, you know. It wasn't about 10 minutes. So I called him and I said, yes, I would love to try out.
His entrance into the group coincided with a shift in the band's sound. It was more toward the psychedelic soul sound of the 70s. It was an exciting time.
I had no idea, you know, I'm thinking, I'm in the Temptations, I'm a superstar, and I'm going to get all the girls, and this is going to be so much fun. I had to meet at 8 o'clock in the morning for rehearsal. I'm like, what's this?
1968 was his coming out party, the nationally televised TCB special with Diana Ross and the Supremes.
I kind of realized why David acted like he did, because I must have did 12 songs out of the 15 songs.
Yeah.
If you're not screwed on right, you will have a tendency to think, hey, I'm the guy.
So is that when you knew that you made it?
We never really even thought of the magnitude of the success that we had.
And success they had. And with that came real-world temptation.
You know, the myth was if you got something and you get some weed or some cocaine, you perform better.
Even though there was more music success, like the 1984 hit Don't Look Any Further with Syeda Garrett, his life was slowly getting out of control.
You know, I would go out in 3 or 4 or 5 days and get high, and I didn't know, you know, one day I found out, I said, what am I doing?
Mm-hmm.
You know.
So he packed up, he moved from L.A. to St. Louis, and moved in with Mom.
Well, when I got here, I was a little messed up, you know. I wasn't on drugs, but she knew. Mm-hmm. Mom can look at the kids. She knew something was wrong. She said, you sit down. And I said, yes, ma'am. But you're in St. Louis, and you're going to go to church with me. It was the best move for me in my life.
He has his life back on track now and does 3 or 4 shows a month across the globe with his Temptations Review. But what he enjoys most is his role as a husband, as a father, and as a St. Louisan.
It's a great life here, a great family town. I love the Cardinals, I love the Rams, I love the Blues. And, you know, I'm a St. Louisan now.
Great story. Love how Mom got him right back on track.
Oh, yeah, moms have a way of doing that, don't they?
Here
oh,
in
man,
St.
They
Louis,
were,
yes, they
are
do.
A great group. That's great to have him.